this video lecture of maths. Today in the first lesson, that is numbers, we are going to start the new concept, that is rounding of numbers. Rounding of numbers means what, or where this concept is used? So I will give you some examples so that you will come to know that where this concept is used or what is this concept is actually mean. See, suppose you want to go to the market to purchase some things, maybe your stationery or some things which you need. Okay, so you need nearly 900 rupees, 963. You need rupees 963. So you want to ask your father to give money, right? So as you want 963 rupees, so just tell me, will you ask for 963, exactly 963 rupees from your father? No. What you will ask? You will ask for 1000 rupees, right? Because this 963 is near to 1000. So you will directly ask, Papa, I want 1000 rupees to purchase some things. Okay, so this year what you have done, instead of asking for 963 rupees, you have asked for 1000 rupees. That is, you have rounded that amount and you have told to your father. So here you have used this concept, rounding of the numbers. Okay, again, suppose you went to the market to purchase a camera, and the cost of camera is suppose rupees 14,058. The cost of camera is rupees 14,058. So if you ask the shopkeeper what is cost of the camera, then what he will say, he will not tell you exactly cost. He will say, the cost of the camera is nearly 14,000. Nearly 14,000. Okay. So what is mean by this? See, sometimes we don't have, or we don't required to get the exact number. We can round off that number and we can tell to other. So here we use this rounding of the number, this concept, rounding of number. Got it? So today we are going to learn how to round off the numbers. We can round off the numbers to nearest 10 or nearest 100 or nearest 1000, nearest 10,000 or nearest lakh. Understood? So today we are going to learn that how to round off the numbers to nearest tens, nearest 100, nearest 1000, nearest 10,000 and nearest lakh. Okay, if you understand the process, if you understand the process of rounding off to nearest tens, nearest 100, nearest 1000, then you can round off the number to any place, that is nearest 10,000 or nearest lakh or 10 lakh or crore, whatever. As we have here up till lakh, so we are going to see that much. First of all, we are going to see how to round off the numbers to the nearest tens. Okay, two examples I have written here. What you have to do when we have to round off the number to nearest tens, the question will be like this: round off the following numbers to nearest tens. Round off the following numbers to the nearest tens. So what you have to do, you know, in this given number, this is number 28,974, okay, and we have to round off this number to the nearest tens. So in this number, which digit is there at tens place? Which digit is there at tens place? Underline that. So this is ones place, this is tens place. Okay, so there is 7 at the tens place. In the tens place, there is 7. Now, after getting the tens place digit, see the next digit of that tens place. So after 7, which digit is there? 4. After 7, which digit is there? 4. This is our tens place digit. After 7, there is 4. So after tens place, if there is 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. You know, we have digits 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So see, after tens place digit, if there is 0, 1, 2, 3 and or 4, then Then, while rounding off, take this number as it is down. While rounding off, take that tens place digit as it is down. For the next digit, write 0. For the next digit, write 0. And remaining all the digits, 982, write as it is. So this is our answer. We have rounded this number. We have rounded 28,974 into nearest tens. So this is our answer, 28,970. Initially it was 28,974, and after rounding to the nearest tens, we got 28,970. You understood what we have done first? Again, I'll repeat the process. First, we have to underline the tens place digit, or circle the tens place digit. Then see the next digit of that tens place. Next digit is 4, and according to the rule, if the next digit is 0, 1, 2, 3 or 4, then take tens place digit as it is down. If the next digit is 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9, then we have to add 1. We have to add 1 in the tens place. But here there is 4, so don't add 1. We need not to add 1. We can take 7 as it is down. And for next digit, write 0. And before all digits, write as it is, 28970. That is 28,970. This is the rounding off form of this number. Let's see the next example so that your idea will get clear. As we have to round off this number, 2,84,166, into the nearest tens. So what we have to do first? First, circle the tens place digit. So in this number, which digit is there at tens place? Ones and tens, right? So this 6. 6 is there at tens place. Circled tens place digit, then what we have to do? See the next digit. Next digit of the tens place. After this digit, there is 6. Now our second rule. If there is 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, the next digit is 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9, then we have to add 1 in the tens place digit. We have to add 1 in the tens place digit. So this 6 plus 1, it will become 7. 6 plus 1, it will become 7. For next digit, write 0 and remain backside all digits, write as it is. Understood? So this way we have rounded off the given number into the nearest tens. Okay. You understood the process. Just you have to keep it in mind this. If there is 0, 1, 2, 3 or 4, then don't add 1. If there is 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9, then we have to add 1 in the particular places. Now here rounding off to the nearest 10, so this rule is applicable for tens place digit. Okay, let's learn rounding off to the nearest 100. So when we have to round off to the nearest 100, same like tens place, here just we have to find out hundreds place digit. So in the first example, where is hundreds place digit? Which is hundreds place digit? 7. Once 10 is 100, 7 is the hundreds place digit. Got it? So here we have to see what we have to do. After doing circle to the hundreds place digit, see the next digit, very next. After 7 there is 1, right? After 7 there is 1. So it comes in the first rule. If there is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, next digit is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, then don't add 1 in this hundreds place digit. Don't add 1. Take it as it is down. 7. Okay. Then for next digits, write 0. There are 2 digits, so 2 zeros. And the digits which are before, write them as it is. Take them as it is down. Got it? Once again, see here. 5,97,467. Find out hundreds place digit. Once 10's 100. Circle it. Done. Check the next digit. Next digit is 6. Then it comes in our second rule. If there is next digit is 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9, then add 1 in the hundreds place digit. So now you have 4 plus 1, it will get 5. Okay, for next two digits, right? 0, 0 and the digits which are before, write them, take them as it is down. So the rounded off form of this number is 5,97,500. As we have rounded off these numbers to the nearest 100. So we got this number after rounding off. Clear? Let's learn rounding off to the nearest 1,000. Rounding off to the nearest 1,000. Again, same rules. The rules which we have seen for rounding off to the nearest tens, for rounding off to the nearest hundreds, are same applicable for thousands or 10,000s or lakhs. Same. Here, as we have to round to the nearest thousands, we have to find out thousands digit. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand. So at thousands place there is 7. Okay. After finding thousands digit, see the next digit to it. After 7. Now see, after 7, which digit is there? 9. Correct. So 9. After 7, there is 9. That means it comes in our second rule. 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9. If there is the next digit is 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9, then we have to add 1 in this thousands place digit. That is 7 plus 1, it will become 8. For next 3 digits, we have to write 3 zeros. And the digits which are before, take them as it is. Okay. So, 3,67,993, after rounding off to the nearest 1,000, we got 3,68,000. Exactly. Understood. Next, 64,547. Round off to the nearest 1,000. So, ones, tens, hundred and thousand. This is our thousands place digit. Once circled to the thousands place digit, we have to underline the next digit. That is 5. Okay. Now, after 4, there is 5. See, that means in the second rule, 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9. Then add 1. So, we need to add 1 in the thousands place digit. 4 plus 1. 5. For next 3 digits, write 3 zeros. And the digit which is before, take it as it is. So, 64,547 becomes 65,000 after rounding off to the nearest 1,000. Understood? So, we have rounded off the numbers to nearest tens, nearest hundreds, nearest thousands. Similarly, we can round off to the nearest 10,000, nearest lakh. Okay, same rules are applicable. Find the particular digit, circle it, then see its next digit. If next digit is 0, 1, 2, 3 or 4, don't add 1. Take the that particular digit which is circled as it is down. For next the digits write 0, 0, 0 and with the digits which are before, take them as it is down. Okay, same rules are applicable for 10,000 also and lakh also. Okay, so pause this video, write this in your notebook and after this we will solve the practice which is based on rounding off the numbers. Okay. So let's solve the practice 1.5 which is based on the rounding off the numbers. Okay, so the first question in this practice is round off to the nearest tens. Round off to the nearest tens. In that first example is example A. 52,256 and this number we have to round off to the nearest tens. This place is very important, tens. Understood? Now what is the first step we have to do? We have to circle the tens place digit. So in this, which is tens place digit? Ones, tens. Correct? So 5 is at tens place, so we will circle it. Understood? Then what is next step? See the next digit to the circle digit, means under tens place digit. The next digit of 5 is 6. Then come in our rules. If the next digit is 0, 1, 2, 3 or 4, then don't add 1 in the tens place digit. If the next digit is 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9, then we have to add 1 in the tens place digit. Then here there is 6, that means what? It comes in our second rule, so we have to add 1 in the tens place digit while rounding off. Clear? So 5 plus 1, 6. For next digit, you write 0, as there is one digit for 1, 0. And the digits which are before, for them, these digits we will write as it is down. We will take them as it is down. Understood? So this is the, this way we can round off to the, round off the given number to the nearest tens. So in this question, the second one example, you have to solve as a homework. Clear? Let's move towards the next question. Question number 2. Round off to the nearest hundreds. Round off to the nearest hundreds. Same rules, same procedure. First find out, as here we have to round off to the nearest hundred. So we need to circle the hundreds place digit. So once tens, hundred, there is 8 and in the hundreds place digit. Okay. After getting hundreds place digit, see the next digit. Next digit is 2. So it comes in our which rule, first or second? First, right? And according to first rule, if there is 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4 as the next digit, don't add 1 in the hundreds place. So this 8 will come as it is down. For next two digits, we'll write 0. Then here, before digits, write, take them as it is. That is 32,823 is rounded off to the 32,800 according to the nearest 100. Okay. Question number 3. Round off to the nearest thousands. Round off to the nearest thousands. So here we need to find thousands place digit. So ones, tens, hundred and thousand. Underline the thousands place digit. Okay. Then see its next digit. Next digit is 2. As there is 2 as the next digit, it comes in our first rule. If 0, 1, 2, 3 or 4 is there next to the given digit, then we don't have to add 1. We have to take as it is, that number we have to take as it is down. For next 3 digits, what we will do? We will put 3 zeros. And the digit which is before, we will take as it is down. So 61,252, after rounding off to the nearest 1000, we have got 61,000. Clear? So in both these questions, second example, example B, and here also B, you have to do as a homework. Let's move towards the next question, question number 4. Round off to the nearest 10,000. 10,000, that means you need to search 10,000 place. See, the number is 66,727. And in this number, 10,000 places, 1, 10, 100, 1,000, 10,000, this 6. 6 is there at 10,000 place. After getting 10,000 place, see its next digit. Successor, successive digits. That is 6. Okay. So as there is 6 as the next digit, it comes in our second rule. That means we need to add 1 in the 10,000 place. 6 plus 1, you will get 7. And for next all digits, you need to put 0 here. As there are 4 digits, after 10,000 place, so you need to put 4 zeros. And there is no digit before the 10,000. Okay. So this way, 66,727, after rounding off to the nearest 10,000, we have got 70,000. Understood? Question number 5, round off to the nearest lakh. So here we need to find out lakh place. It is 2,87,123. So 1, 10, 100, 1,000, 10,000 and lakh. At lakh place there is 2. So we have circled it. Then see the next digit. There is 8 after 2. So if there is 8, that means we need to add 1 in the lakh place. So 2 plus 1. 2 plus 1, 3. For next all digits we need to write, we have to write zeros. As there are 5 digits after 2, so we have put 5 zeros. Clear? So this 2,87,123, after rounding off, we have got 3 lakh. See, 2,87,123, it is near to 3 lakh. So when we have to round off into nearest lakh, we have got it as a 3 lakh. Understood? So this way we can round off to the nearest tens, nearest 100, nearest 1000, 10,000 or nearest lakh. Okay, so see the next question, question number 6. It is HOTS question, higher order thinking question. Using digits 5, 2, 4, 7 and 1, write a number which rounds to 54,300. That means they have given here number after rounding off. After rounding off that particular number, we have got 54,300. Then which will be the possible number using these digits? That number we have to find out. So see here, if you'll observe this number, 54,300. Now if you'll see this number, it is round, it is roundage to the nearest tens, hundred, thousands, 10,000 or lakh. 54,300. It has been rounded to the nearest 100. How can you say nearest 100? Because there are two zeros. See, when they round off to the nearest 100, we have got two zeros at the end. Understood? Similarly, this, as here there are two zeros at the end, that means here this number is rounded to the nearest 100. Hundreds plus digit is rounded off. Okay, so see now how to get that number. This digit is rounded, right? That means these first two digits will be taken. First two digits are taken as it is down. So they will remain same as it is. This first two digits will remain same because this hundreds place digit is rounded. One stands 100. This is rounded off. So this first two digits will remain as it is. So 5 and 4. 5 and 4 will come at this two place. Thousands and 10,000. Okay. Now this place, hundreds place is rounded off. See, when we rounded off hundreds place digit, if there is the next digit is 2, so we have taken 8 as it is, but next digit is wherever, next digit is more than 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9, then we have added 1. Similarly here, if you see there is 300, okay, 3 at hundreds place. But in the digits, given digits, there is no 3. That means what? As there is 3 at the hundreds place digit and here in the given digits, there is no 3. That means what? This 3 is rounded by adding 1. By adding 1, then the before digit of 3 is 2. And is there 2 in the given digit? Yes, there is 2. So there is 2 at the hundreds place. Now remain 7 and 1. See, this 2 is rounded by adding 1. 2 plus 1, 3. Correct? So the next digit must be 2. To convert 2 into 3 while rounding off, the next digit must be in this second rule, 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9. Then only adding 1 is possible. So there are two digits, 7 and 1. So which digit must be there as after 2? 7. Okay, then 1 will come at the end. Now see, if you round off this number, we will get this number. 54,271, when we will round off to the nearest 100, we will get 54,300. See, at hundreds place there is 2, that means we will circle 2, then after 2 there is 7. 7, that means in the second rule, add 1. So we will add 1 in the 2. 2 plus 1, 3. For next two digits, we will put 0 zeros. And these two digits we will take as it is. Okay, so the number is 54,271. Understood? So if you have any doubt in this practice 1.5, you are free to ask. Also, second example in each questions, you have to solve as a homework. Okay? In this concept, if you have any doubt, ask me in comment section or WhatsApp group. So thank you and have a nice day.